Okay, what's good? It's your boy Eli Love. Now we're gonna sit up here, we're gonna talk about the problems in the ghetto. You understand? We're gonna get into that. And we're gonna talk about why the ghetto is so fucked up. You understand? Alright. What's the worst things in our community? Give y'all time to think about that. The worst things in our community is the drugs, the violence, the prostitution, the crime, the lack of knowledge and opportunities, no unity or loyalty, a lot of jealous and envy, homosexuality, diseases, crooked police, poverty, social media, racism, child support, and government assistance. You feel me? That's crazy. But let's talk about what can help repair the ghetto. Let's talk about that. Let's talk about what will help repair the ghetto. Okay, bam. Show more love and respect to one another. That'll help. If in a position to provide opportunities for the less fortunate, that'll help. Provide more affordable health care. Definitely that. You feel me? Because a lot of people out here be sick and be going through stuff and not really, you know, where they can afford to pay for proper health care. That's crazy. You feel what I'm saying? What else? More drug and rehabilitation centers in the hood. That'll help. That'll help also. You know, more strong black positive role models. That'll help. You know, shelter for the homeless. More homeless shelters, man. They got more fucking jails. They building jails before they build homeless shelters and rehabilitation centers, man, for people who are on drugs and stuff like that and more. You know, they doing more of that, and that's fucking crazy, man. That is crazy. I'm trying to tell you. We need more black-owned business in the community, too, man. We need more of them. They need cops to wear body cam, audio, and video at all times when on duty. And if arrest is made and the cop didn't follow proper protocol during the arrest, that he is suspended or terminated, depending on the circumstances of the charge, immediately, and all charges are thrown out. Definitely. And there's a lot of stuff that was on my mind, so, you know what I mean? I couldn't really think of it off top, but, you know, I can, you know, just go in and I read it, because this is a lot of stuff that can help the ghetto, man, help us where it cannot be a ghetto, where it can be a community. Everybody working, everybody getting money, everybody doing what they want to do, you know what I mean, to live, you feel me? In the right way, in positive way. Install more surveillance cameras in the neighborhood. I think that'll be good. If they had more cameras in the hood that's saying what's going on, a lot of crime wouldn't happen. You feel what I'm saying? That will cut the crime rate down a lot. 24-hour armed security in the hood. You feel what I'm saying? That'll help. So that'll knock down the crime rate also. But why they ain't gonna do that? Because they don't care. They want you to kill yourself. You feel what I'm saying? They want you to kill everybody else. You know, less niggas on the earth. That's what they want you to do. You feel what I'm saying? They ain't trying to fucking help us, man. Get on our feet. How the fuck somebody can come from another country? Another motherfucking country, man. And get good credit. And we live in these neighborhoods that these fucking, you know, other races come over here and open up business in, man. That's fucked up, man. Straight up. You know? And let's talk about this kind of like on the topic too, you know. Like, okay. In this whole segment, I'm trying to touch on these things because these are the things that's destroying our community. Drugs, violence, prostitution, crime, lack of knowledge and opportunities, no unity or loyalty, jealousy and envy, homosexuality, diseases, crooked police, poverty, social media, racism, child support, and government assistance. Now, in a few of these things I was touching on, talking about, some of these things I didn't touch on, and that's what I'm about to get to. Diseases. This will cut down the, you know what I mean, right here. This shit right here, this will cut down the population of less STDs and for the future, definitely. You know what I mean? Mandatory health checkups twice a year for the next 5 years, and after that, once a year until all diseases are cured or even non-existent, and those who fail to do so will face jail time. And those who test positive for any deadly diseases will be marked in a private area to where only them or whoever they decide to have sex with will see. Okay. Basically, like, you get tested. It's mandatory that you get tested. It's mandatory that you get tested. You feel what I'm saying? And if you don't, you'll get a couple warnings maybe, but eventually, if you don't show up to get tested, you will face jail time. Now, those who's handicapped, maybe you can schedule out an appointment where you come out to their house and check them, but it's mandatory that you get tested. And if you got a deadly disease that's not curable, then you are marked in a certain place on your body. And it could be where nobody else could see it, but you and whoever you decide to sleep with. Real shit. That'll cut out the fucking diseases. You feel me? That'll cut out the majority of the fucking diseases you can catch from just having sex. That should've cut out all that, yo. Cause if I see a little mark on a bitch, like, oh no, we ain't finna do nothing. Like, that's dead. You got that mark, bitch. Fuck out of here. You know what I'm saying? Like, shit. It's mandatory. Like, anybody I deal with, they know I ain't got no problem taking a test. You feel me? And I hope you feel the same way. And I hope you had the same energy, bitch. I'm trying to tell you. Or it's like, I don't want to fuck with you. Straight up. I mean, what else? Build more youth programs. Definitely, we can do that, man. Build more youth programs where we got more, like, you know, like people wanting to, you know, put money into the hood where little kids that can't afford to play sports can play. You feel what I'm saying? You never know, man. You know, next Jerry Rice could come out of anywhere. You know what I mean? The next, you know, Eddie George or whatever, man. Like, or that next Emmitt Smith or whatever. Michael Irvin or whatever could come out of anywhere, man. You feel what I'm saying? Real shit. What else? More affordable college tuition and trade school programs. That'll be awesome. You feel what I'm saying? Because a lot of times people can't pay to go to school to get the RN or CDLs or mechanic or whatever you want to do. Like, sometimes people can't afford to pay for it. You feel me? We need more money invested in that, man, especially. To criminalize drugs and prostitution charges. That's crazy, and I know y'all want me to explain that. But cause somebody decide to use drugs and you catch it with them, locking them up ain't helping. Bottom line, that's not helping. That's not fucking helping. You locking somebody up because they got an addiction and shit, it's not going to help them. It's actually going to make them worse. Because everybody know you, niggas still getting high in fucking jail. So it's like, if they was a junkie on the street, if they go in jail and get access to it, they're going to get high in jail. Simple as that. So it's like, come on, man. Like, at least if you catch it with them, make them go to a program. At least have them in a due time in a rehab the way they can't get out or something like that, but locking them up for it ain't helping it. Now, you want to charge a woman for selling her ass, that should be her own will. Sad to say, you know, you shouldn't lock her up, at least put her in a program to where, like, some shit like that if she get caught doing it or some shit like that, but, you know, and it's like, hey, she need help if she out here selling herself. You feel what I'm saying? So why lock up for it? No, she need help for that. And this the last but not the least. Homosexuality should not be exposed to kids. That's my opinion. Because they got this gay shit and everything now, as far as cartoons, movies, shows that come on TV every day, movies, like all types of shit. They got all types of gay shit out here and it's destroying these kids, and a lot of times they making choices to be gay before they even have an opportunity to even know about it. That's sad, man. That shit crazy. All you niggas out here wearing dresses and pocketbooks and shit, like, you niggas is cold bitches. It's like, if you gonna be a faggot, nigga, at least be a faggot, but not in front of the kids. If you gonna be gay, homosexuality, whatever, nigga, whatever the fuck they wanna call it, like, you shouldn't do it in front of the kids, man. And then you gay motherfuckers adopting kids, that's sad. And this all the shit I'm touching on that's destroying the hood, what we call the hood, which shouldn't be a hood. It should be more of a community where it's, you know what I mean, it's nice and shit, but it's not going to be like that because a lot of motherfuckers is just fucking the whole game up. This is modern day Sodom and Gomorrah, I believe, that the Bible speak on. That's what we living in. We living in those times, you know. A motherfucker turn their back on you, whatever, stab you in the back, and he can grow up with you or she can grow up with you and just fuck you over big time and don't feel no remorse. Pure evil. You know what I'm saying? You feel what I'm saying? Motherfuckers out here is pure fucking evil. And this is some things that I be doing and shit, trying to, you know, stay sane and all that good shit. You feel what I'm saying? But there's a lot of things I just wanted to touch on. You know what I'm saying? Just, you know, so people can wake up. To wake the fuck up. Because a lot of people out here is lost. And I'm not perfect. I have my flaws. But most of this shit, I never took place in. You know what I'm saying? Like, I smoked my little weed. I done drunk a little bit, so I done did the drugs. And, you know, I done had people try to put their fucking hands on me, so I anticipated in some fucking violence. You know what I'm saying? You know, but some shit I got written down here, I never did. Like, I'm all about unity and loyalty, and I'm all against jealous and envy. I hate a nigga that just don't like you for no fucking reason or just want to be jealous of you for no reason. You ain't gotta have money for a nigga to be jealous of you at all. I witnessed that firsthand. A nigga hate the smile on your face. That's how real it is. That's how real it is. A nigga hate the fucking smile on your face, man. Not because you did anything to him or anything or did anything. The nigga hate the smile on your face. So it ain't about, like, a lot of niggas get money and say a nigga's hating on them and shit. It's like, you ain't gotta have money for a nigga to hate on you. But you can have money and have a nigga hate on you. You feel what I'm saying? It's like, haters don't got no fucking boundaries. They hate on everything, nigga. They hate that the fucking sky is blue. You feel me? They hate that grass is green. I hate because you got a job. I hate because you dealing with a woman that he want. I hate just because you done been different places. I hate just any fucking thing. He won't like your shoes. He won't like your pants. He might not like your shirt. Nigga, he might not like your hat. The fuck? I hate the color of your skin, nigga. I hate the hair on your face, nigga. You feel what I'm saying? I hate because you ain't a bitch ass nigga like him. You feel me? I hate every fucking thing. Let me tell you something. I hate every fucking thing, nigga. You feel what I'm saying? I hate everything. He don't give a fuck, nigga. He hate on your child, nigga. She hate on your child, nigga. The fuck? You niggas is goofy, man. And you being friends with fucking haters, nigga. I roll dolo, nigga. The fuck? You hanging with fucking haters, nigga. What the fuck is wrong with you? Nigga, they hating on you. Behind closed doors. Some of them do it in your face and say, yo, I'm playing. I'm just joking. I'm just fucking with you. No, he's serious. That nigga hate you, man. The fuck? Goofy ass niggas, man. I roll dolo, nigga. You feel me? Hanging with these fucking haters, man. Stop hanging with these fucking haters, nigga. Fuck wrong with you, nigga. And you bougie ass bitches out here too. And you got a lot of bougie ass bitches out here who hate. You feel me? Bitches hate for no reason. You feel what I'm saying? I done seen bitches hate. I done live with a fucking hater, nigga. I know what the fuck I'm talking about. I live with a fucking hater, nigga. Get the fuck up out of there. That's what I did. But I was living with a fucking hater, nigga. Bitch that just wanna hate on bitches for no reason. You feel me? I'm trying to tell you, yo. I hate fucking haters, yo. Stay the fuck away from me if you hate her. You a hater, nigga. Don't even look at me, nigga. But see, me, I'ma smack the shit out of you, say some hating shit. Especially if I don't know you. You might get a pass if you my peoples. Cause I got family that hate, nigga. This hating shit is going crazy out here. It's like a disease. Niggas is catching that hater shit. The fuck? You niggas is goofy, man. Fucking hating ass niggas. Keep hating and shit. You ain't got nothing better to do than hate. One thing about me, I don't give a fuck what you doing. I ain't gonna judge you unless it's some super dumb shit that you on, super goofy shit you might be on, where if you know what I mean, you just want to hurt people for no reason or some shit, like if you a bully or some shit like that, then like, or you're a homosexual or whatever the fuck you might be, like I ain't gonna speak on what you doing, and I don't give a fuck what you doing. That's your business, nigga. You feel what I'm saying? But if I see what the fuck you doing affecting the kids, yeah, I'ma say something. But another nigga, a random Joe or a random Jane, whoever the fuck he is or she is, I don't do no hating, man. I mind my fucking business and I worry about what I got going on. You niggas is haters, man. Fuck. You niggas is haters, yo. Not only are you haters, you bitch ass niggas. A lot of y'all are fucking down low. A lot of y'all are fucking rob your man if he got the bigger bag. A lot of y'all set him up. A lot of y'all tell on him. A lot of y'all say a lot of hating shit to him on the low. A lot of y'all lie to him. A lot of y'all steal from him. Y'all some bitches. You feel what I'm saying? All y'all niggas, man. All y'all crab ass niggas, yo. You feel me? And those who don't understand that shit, I ain't talking about no gangbanger shit. I'm just talking about all you fake ass niggas, yo. All you haters. And all you hating bitches. That bitch look better than you, you think. Got the bigger bag and you don't like her. You want to talk about the bitch shoes. You want to talk about the bitch hair. You want to say her ass ain't real. You want to say she paid for them titties. You want to say hating shit. You feel what I'm saying? You want to say hating shit. That bitch still with her baby father. And you hating on her. That bitch got all this, her kids by the same nigga. And you hating on her. You want to make up a lie. Or even if she don't, you want to hate on the fact that she got different baby daddies. But she with the second one. But the nigga might treat her good and be loyal to you. The first nigga probably was a fucking clown. Probably was a fuck boy. You feel what I'm saying? You want to hate on her. You feel me? She got that promotion. You want to hate. You feel what I'm saying? She got that new car. You want to hate, bitch. I don't like that car. I wouldn't drive that one. Nah, that ain't my type. I would have got something smaller or bigger. You a hating ass bitch. Shut the fuck up. You goofy ass bitch. Your nigga probably out here driving your car, picking bitches up in your car. Probably don't even got a job. Probably fucking bitches in your house, you stupid bitch. And you want to hate. Fuck out of here. I ain't got no problem shitting on a bitch. Fuck all that other goofy shit they tell a nigga. You don't need to talk to women like that. No, these bitches need to wake up, man. I ain't talking about to the queens. I'm talking about to these little hood rat hating ass bitches with no money. Fuck. You know what I mean? Bitch, you got a new bag, but your son ain't got no shoes on. He ain't got no new shoes on. You feel me? You got your head done, bitch. He walking around with this dingy ass shirt. Fucking shoes falling to the ground, bitch. Oh, but you fly and shit, though. You feel what I'm saying? Goofy ass, bitch. Stop hating. You feel me? I ain't said enough, man. Cause you niggas be hating. Goofy ass niggas, man. Check out my music on my page too, nigga. Shit hot, man. All this trash ass music. A lot of this, now let's talk about the music. Yo, this shit, a lot of this music is fucking garbage, yo. Oh my god. Matter of fact, we're gonna play some new shit. You know what I mean? That people be popping, like niggas get playing shit on YouTube and the spins and shit. And the shit I be talking about, niggas, like, I'm making sense though. These niggas is goofy. Hold on 1 second. Let me find this bullshit on the phone. What's the name? I don't even remember this shit. I don't even remember. I can't even pull the shit up. I don't even remember the goddamn name of the song. But I just heard some bullshit on the radio. Yo, this shit is trash. I mean, shout out to niggas who still rapping, like Kendrick Lamar, J. Cole, and you know what I mean? Fabulous, and Jadakiss, and The Lox, all period. But all the niggas who still rap sometimes and shit, like, these niggas ain't rapping. Yo, this shit is trash. You niggas is goofy, yo. This shit is trash, yo. Ugh. Niggas wearing dresses and shit like, come on, yo. Niggas wearing fucking dresses in the videos now. You feel me? Certain shit I don't even feel comfortable clicking on. One time I clicked on some shit on Worldstar, a nigga deep throating the fucking 8K47 and shit. Like, these niggas is, what the fuck are these niggas on, yo? Shit is trash, you know. I'm trying to tell you, you know. I'm trying to tell you. I'm gonna play you some of this shit I be hearing, you know. Shit is trash, yo. This the ad. Hold up. I don't like this shit. Ain't might not be trash. I just don't even understand the shit. I can't understand what the... I can't listen to this whole shit. That shit is garbage. You feel what I'm saying? Check out my music on my Instagram. I'm on Instagram, LarryLove11587@yahoo. No, that's my fucking email. But yeah, LarryLove11587. You feel what I'm saying? On Instagram, man. I got like little freestyles and shit on there where, you know, I ain't rapping on no beat, but I got shit on beat, but not on there. You feel what I'm saying? But a lot of these niggas is trash, yo. And I'm out, yo.